Hello and welcome back, my beautiful froggy army, to another video. As you can see by the good old title, today we are building a bridge. This is a kid core staple in my opinion. You gotta have just a huge bridge on your island, on your kid core island, so I'm very excited to get into it with you guys. Let me of course show you the area, so I will go into the story of why I decided to put it right here, but I am basically gonna be putting the bridge directly behind the laundromat that I built and have it lead from the back of the laundromat outwards, you know, towards another area. We're basically gonna pick up this little plant right here and we're gonna go straight back through there. So first I'm gonna start building up the bridge, and while I do this very tedious monotonous terraforming, I am gonna tell you the whole situation that I went through when I was figuring out this video. Okay, so initially I wanted to build a little candy shop because that's been on my list of builds to do on my island for a while now. I have some codes downloaded for it. I even went and downloaded more codes and like started gathering items. I was like, okay, next video is gonna be a candy shop and it's gonna be sweet. So I got all that together and all that was left for me to do was to pick the area, right? Which should in theory be the easiest part, but no, you are wrong and I was wrong. It was not the easiest part. I don't know why. For some reason, all I was doing for like 20 minutes was like running back and forth on my island, just staring at the floor, being like, should I put the candy shop here or would it look better over here? And I don't know why. On this island, it's so hard for me to like put things places. Like, I just don't know where to put anything. It's such a hard decision. Why is this so difficult? But I digress. Ultimately, I was like, okay, I kind of want to put it up on another level or something. I kind of want to put it behind the laundromat a little bit. But then I was like, okay, well, then I'm going to have to like, you know, build up two levels and maybe I should just connect it with a bridge, just have a little bridge. And I was like, no, I shouldn't put a tiny bridge. I should put a big bridge. Oh, wait, I can start doing the big bridge because I've wanted to do that on my kid core island. I for sure want to have a huge bridge. So there you can see my map. And that's how huge I decided to make it. It is absolutely massive. So I actually decided, instead of just making the bridge and being done with it, because I was initially just going to build like the platform, you know, the terraforming for the bridge, and then start working on the candy shop. So I started recording me building the bridge just to be like, oh, you know, like first I had to build this bridge before the candy shop to like show in the video. But then I was like, no, I can't just leave this here, all this empty space on the sides. I can't just build this massive bridge and just be done about it. No, this has to be a full build. This is gonna be a video. So here we are. So instead of the candy shop that I actually prepared for, I ended up doing this. And sometimes that's just how life is. You prepare and then just the unexpected happens. So you have to expect the unexpected if you ever want to be prepared in life. I don't know what I'm saying. Don't listen to me. But I basically just decided to make it like a froggy bridge because I was like, you know what looks cute on the water? Frogs, obviously. So I started doing these little like floating little pieces of land to put stuff on, and as you saw, I put down the little froggy snack, which is so cute. But yeah, pretty much I just wanted the bridge to be like going over some water because I know my island is going to be having a lot of water features because it is very much frog themed. So I started getting a path for my main city area that's actually just like a water looking path, and it's just gonna be a very wet island. It's very soggy. You can't wear socks on this island because you're gonna have soggy socks and nobody likes soggy socks. So please come with some rain boots or just go barefoot, honestly. Like, if that's what you gotta do, that's what you gotta do. And since this was pretty unplanned, I didn't really know what I was doing with the water and stuff like that. I only knew that I wanted these little floating islands and, you know, to put stuff on top of it and make it all cute. So I just made just like a huge blob with like straight lines on this side, which is definitely a look. You'll see once it's done and it's almost done, like it looks cute. I like it. But if you know me and if you followed my last island before, you know that I really don't, not that I dislike, but I'm very not used to doing like straight lines on my island. I'm not used to doing straight lines for my pathing or for my cliffs or whatever. I like to make them look as natural as possible and have like curves and like all that kind of stuff. So while it came out very cute, to me, I don't know, it looked too manicured, and while that's kind of exactly the vibe I probably should have gone for, since this is like kind of next to a city and it's probably like a man-made canal or something, I just didn't like it. So I mean, like I said, you'll see in a second, I ended up adding some curves to the other side, and then I came back and fixed this side, so this is not the finished version. And the Kurobe lanterns are just some of the most chef's kiss items in the game. I'm so happy that they added Kurobe furniture and like frog stuff right as I was deciding to do kind of like a frog themed island. It just was absolutely meant to be. Absolutely. So here you can see the finished little waterway. Like I said, it looks pretty cute, you know? These straight lines on the sides, they don't look that bad. I did round off the top two edges and the bottom two, but as you'll see here, I did have the idea to just kind of make it more curved, like just add some little squiggles. So it's like a winding river, you know? And I do think it comes out better, in my opinion. Of course, if you want to recreate this or whatever, just like do whatever you want. When I'm doing the curves on the right side here, it looks a lot more difficult than it actually is. Like, I made it way too hard on myself. You'll see when I go back on the first one that I did, it was just so much easier. Like, so if you want to do like curved rivers like this, like don't pay attention to this part. I make it look so difficult. It's really not that hard. Once I redo the other side, you'll see how easy it is. So yeah, I was also kind of hesitant to do this because this is like very natural. This isn't really like too kidcore in my opinion. Like once I add the bridge, it'll look a lot better, but this is pretty like naturey and natural. We got some, you know, natural looking rivers, and we got some little frogs and stuff like that, the little lanterns. I wish the lanterns were like green, like bright green, the Kurobe lanterns, like the little Kurobe snack, but they are stone and that's fine. It's still so cute, but it does give a more natural look, you know? And this is right next to the laundromat, which is like smack dab in like the heart of my city area. So I was a little hesitant. I was like, is this gonna be like too much natural stuff in my city? But I don't know, we're just gonna make it work. I really like how it came out, and I will go into like my plans for what's gonna go like around this and behind this, mostly behind this. But if you saw my map earlier, it does go pretty far back, and we're already like kind of in the back area of my island. That's where the bridge leads to, so that's kind of where I was already planning to have like the little swampy frog area. That's where I want to put all of my frog villager homes and have like a lot of bamboo and a lot of water and waterfalls and stuff like that, and try to make it as kidcore as I can while still being like natural looking. So we're gonna see how well I manage that. It's already been very fun and interesting trying to do like a kidcore city because I've never done city stuff before, and I'm trying to make it look like a city but also like cutesy and kidcore, and trying to incorporate frogs as much as I can. Really, the frog back area of my island is going to be like the main froggy central hub. It's kind of hard to include it in the city area, but you know, just throw some Kurobe snacks in there and you're good. Speaking of Kurobe stuff though, I have recently been getting a lot more into like the Sanrio stuff, I guess because of honestly the Sanrio amiibos. I've always liked Sanrio, but I guess after the amiibos and like seeing all the furniture, I just realized like the potential that they have, like how cute they are. Not just for you know, Animal Crossing stuff, but in general, and I feel like a lot of people have had the same experience, whatever. So I actually ordered some Kurobe stuff off of Mercari, which is kind of like eBay or whatever, you just like resell stuff. So I ordered like this little Kurobe like hamburger keychain plushie, and it was so cute. And there was this Kurobe vintage like candy dispenser that I saw that I was so like crazy in love with. I was like, oh, this is so cute, this is so fun, this is so unique, like I love this little candy dispenser, dude, like I want to buy that and like put peanut M&Ms in it or something. And it looked like super cute in the pictures, and it was like vintage, and it's got like the little thingy. I'll just put a picture of it. And it was only like 20 something dollars, I think it was like $22 plus shipping, and I was like, oh, like that's great, that's a pretty decent price for like a little vintage kind of cute Sanrio thing, so I bought it. And I waited, you know, like you do when you buy something, and it came in the mail, and it said it was in my mailbox. So I go in my mailbox, and all I see in there is like this tiny itty bitty little box, and I was like, surely this can't be it. I don't know why it said delivered. It's probably just not here yet. So I come back in, and lo and behold, the label says it's from Mercari, and I'm like, oh no. This box is 4x4x4 inches. Oh no, because here I am thinking that this is like a decent sized candy dispenser that can fit peanut M&Ms in it, you know, like through the little chute, and it comes out. So I open it, and there's like two layers of like thick bubble wrap around it, and I'm like, oh no. Oh no, it's even smaller than this. So I open it, and I was so sad to say that it literally is not even the length of my hand, like from my palm to the tips of my fingers. It is a like literal McDonald's toy looking little gum dispenser or candy dispenser. I think it does function. I don't know what I could put in there. Probably like Nerds or something, like a tiny, tiny candy. But I was just like, what? In the pictures, it looked so huge. What the heck? So I was a little bit disappointed, but it's still real cute. And I'm glad that I own it. It's cute. It's actually vintage. It's from either 1988 or 1995. It says both of those dates on it, but it's really cute and I'm glad I have it. But yeah, that's my story of like, you know, like when you order things and they come and they're just absolutely microscopic, which I should have asked for the size before I ordered it, I guess, if I was really so concerned about it. But I'm so glad that I have it and that I ordered it and that I snagged it. So yeah, that's been my adventure with buying Sanrio stuff online. I'm just gonna be more careful now and ask for sizes in advance if it's something that I want to be functional. But anyways, while I was saying that, you could probably see me here continuing and fixing up this left side and adding those little curves like I was talking about. And it really is so much easier just once you have all of the water built up first. All I had to do was like add three little things of dirt, you know, and like all you do is round off the top and the bottom and it makes that little curve. It's so easy. Definitely if you're gonna like recreate this or something, just build the whole thing first. Do the straight line of water and then add the curves after. To me it was just like way easier. And here fixing up this top part, it was so difficult for some reason. I don't know why. Waterscaping is just not my strong suit like ever, and I just kept messing up over and over again trying to like get this shape that I wanted. You know, it's a pain sometimes. I can't lie. I wish we had some sort of like mass terraforming or like mass waterscaping tool, like at least to do like a 4x4 like spot of it or something. That would make it go so much faster. When you have to build like a huge area, it's just so time consuming. And like the fact that I flattened, I'm starting to think that was not a good idea, like flattening my entire island before I built this stuff. Like I had to make the river, like the Frog River, but yeah, that means I have to build up every single cliff from scratch, which now that I'm thinking about it is gonna be a pain. Oh my goodness, would you look at that. So I did decide to add some little cliffs on the right and the left, just extending outwards so I could add some little waterfalls, and you'll see me do that in a sec. But yeah, I'm definitely gonna be adding more to these cliffs and gonna be, you know, putting something up there, probably like a frog house up there, one of my frog villagers. I don't know yet, but this is not finished, this back half of all these cliffs, so don't think it's just gonna end abruptly like that. That is not the plan for it. So yeah, here I go ahead and add the water, just some little waterfalls just to make it more interesting, because I thought that was very cute. So yeah, here you can see the finished stuff, the finished little water things, and I think it came out so cute. It's a little empty on the sides of the river, but that's okay. We just haven't put anything there yet. But I did try to do this path first, this custom design with like this little pastel wood brick. No, not bricks. Just wood, Raven. This pastel wood moment. And I really like this design. I think it's really good. And I liked it because it had green in it, and I wanted to incorporate some green on whatever custom design I chose. But I did end up cycling through a couple of designs. I didn't end up liking this one because I thought it was a little too pastel. I'm trying not to go for like a very soft pastel kind of vibe on the island. I'm trying to go for more bright colors. If some pastel is here or in and there, you know, on some spots around the island, that's fine. But I kind of want to have like brighter colors, like very, very bright and happy, but not primary colors, just like the rainbow, but bright, you know? So then I added this fence. I thought this was a good fence, especially because it was blue. I know I said I wanted green stuff to be here because frog, but I thought the blue was a good tie-in with the laundromat that is right below it, kind of, you know, blending the two areas together. So after putting all of the fencing down, I decided I didn't really like the custom design on the bottom. So if you like that design, I'll try to leave that and all the rest of these that I try in the description. But I did try to switch over to this one, which is like a little star bridge pattern, but I didn't really like how the stars looked. I thought it was like too much like sprinkles or something. Not really a huge fan. So then after that one, I tried this little pastel brick path, which I thought could be, you know, fun. Shake it up a little bit, some bricks instead of wood. But I didn't end up liking this one either. I thought it was a little too busy. So finally I landed on this one, which is much more muted compared to the other ones, but I thought this tied in so good with the surrounding areas. I thought it kept in the little green frog theme, and actually the same creator has the same path, but just like with this little stuff on top. I don't really know what to call this, but like these little squiggles, it's very subtle, but it's there. So I decided to go with that one because I thought that one was a little more interesting, just that little extra spice in it, you know? So like I've said, this little top area with these cliffs, like I'm gonna extend that and push that back, gonna continue building up those cliffs behind there. So that is still unfinished, but as you walk down the bridge, you see all the little froggies and the Kropi lanterns and the cute little waterfalls and the river. I really, really like how it all came out. It is so cute and very green, very green. We have a nice blue area behind it, or in front of it, and then we have the nice green area. So yeah, I really like how it all looks. I don't know about you. I think I kind of want to replace that one lonely regular looking frog model with a Kropi snack because he kind of looks out of place, but yeah, that's how it came out. Thank you so much for watching this video. I really hope you enjoyed it. I had so much fun on this build, even though it was a little more unexpected and kind of unplanned, but sometimes it just be like that, and I'm so glad that it came out so good. Anyways, if you want to recreate this on your island, I know that large bridges are not my original idea. Plenty of people have done that, but if you wanna, you know, use my same codes and use the same items as me, go for it. I am here for inspiration. Steal my ideas, take them. Here you go, I'm handing them to you. And if you want to get more ideas, you could go ahead and join my Discord server. We have a ton of channels for inspiration, trading, all of the stuff you would want to do in Animal Crossing. And if you want to catch up with me more, go ahead and follow me on Twitter, Instagram, TikTok. I would love to see you on there. So with that, I'm gonna get going. I have some rice to cook for dinner. So thank you again so much for watching. Don't forget to like this video, and I will see you in the next one.